are tale of the tape for this strawweight fight. Here once more, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC strawweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, Tatiana Suarez. And now introducing her opponent, fighting out of the red corner, presenting the former UFC strawweight champion, Carla Cookie Monster Esparza.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Dateline Anaheim, California, USA. We are inside Honda Center, where women were ushered into the UFC in this very building back in 2013.
In this very building, you understood how big a star Ronda Rousey was. This place was as loud as it's ever been. Can you get the crowd on their feet tonight, as Ronda Rousey did way back
in the night? When Ronda Rousey made that walk at UFC 157, truly a sports moment where most people remember exactly where they were.
You will never forget the moment you saw Ronda hit the curtain in Anaheim.
Push kick there to the body. Tries to work it into a takedown.
Guillotine jump.
Oh, that sub is tight.
Oh, she got out. How good is that? That's a powerful strike from bottom position. She's moving her head pretty good on the ground here, avoiding a lot of these shots. Well, the ground and pound has been on point tonight. Good work here by Esparza.
She is so dominant from the top position.
Well, the ground and pound is there once again. Strong work here by Carla Esparza.
Great defense to stay safe.
Another ground and pound strike lands.
Oh, she's in trouble, dude.
Lands a big elbow there. Oh, nice job by her to posture up there. Now we'll see if she can maintain that separation.
And now she has her back.
Esparza's really pressing now, and she's got her opponent's belly firmly placed on the mat.
That was nice.
Good work from the top here by Esparza. And there it is, another strike on the ground, gets through. She's trying to pass the guard here. Ooh, gets denied by the bottom
fighter. She got stopped. She got stopped right in her tracks. Great job by the bottom fighter.
Oh, what a strike from her there out of that bottom position. She is offense all the time. So Esparza is back in half guard, standing over her opponent and landing a nice combination of strikes. So staying active enough for the referee and really making these shots count.
She's not being overzealous. She's not looking for too much. She's taking her time. Eventually, she hopes that she will find a shot that finishes the fight.
Stop. Round two straight ahead.
Okay, you lost that last round. You listen to me? That round's gone. You need to sprawl harder. You need to keep that jab in the face.
All right, there's the horn. Let us now check out some of the action from that round, DC. What a display of striking.
Yeah, John, she did a great job. I mean, she knew exactly what she needed to do, and she mixed everything up beautifully, right? Every punch landed to a kick. Whenever her opponent thought kicks, she would follow up with punches. It was a masterclass in striking over the course of that round.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Go. All right, round two.
Oh.
Hook shot lands.
Keep going with that.
Oh, nicely done to block the strike and counter with the jab.
Good jab.
And a nice job at least staying upright on that. Back and forth we go. Oh, combination striking at its best. Another great sequence out of her there.
She is just throwing everything with so much confidence. Every time she throws, she believes that she is going to land, and to this point, she has done just that.
Ooh, pretty good uppercut. Hey, there it is, her first takedown of the fight. She told us in our fighter meeting Thursday, at some point, I will take her down. She didn't expect it to take this long, but here it is.
She really had to work to get this first takedown, and she never gave up on herself. Continued to press, continued to shoot, continued to level change. Now she finally has secured her first takedown.
Under 3 minutes to go here in round two.
In the half guard.
While working pretty effectively from the top here. Nice ground and pound by Esparza.
She has no answer, so continue to feed her the question. Right hand after right hand from the top position. She's stepping over the mount here.
Well, this is a tough fighter to buck off. Very good pressure and work here by Carla Esparza.
Great shot from the top position.
The ground strike's starting to pile up. Nice positional control here. Most fighters will tell you offensive wrestling is the hardest, most exhausting thing.
Especially if you're just running the guy over, John, and then he just gets up.
Oh, effective utilization of the ground and pound here by Esparza.
On to the mount.
Transition. 30 seconds to go in the round. Big round for her there. Let's look back at some of the highlights, DC, and a lot of these pictures going to be rooted in that killer ground and pound.
Yeah, she got the fight where she needed it to be. You knew that if she was going to be ahead, if she was going to be the one winning, she needed to be on top, landing that beautiful ground and pound. She got the fight where she wanted it, and you see the result. Her dominating the action at the close of the round.
Ready. Ready.
Third round underway. Oh, nice shot to the body, connects for her there. Somewhat surprising, we didn't see a lot of body work from her earlier in the fight, but she is getting after it now. Back to the jab now.
Oh, big elbow.
Takedown defense holds up. She wanted out of that clinch and able to get out.
Oh, guillotine, guillotine here.
That guillotine is tight.
That guillotine choke is tight. She's got her in her full guard locked in. It's only a matter of time before she makes her tap. Oh, we're in the fight now. What a struggle for the submission.
Oh, she's out, and I don't mean unconscious. How did she escape? All right, well, she continues to try to set up submissions here, but there it is. Gets denied again.
Once again, the submission is denied. This is just great submission defense. I mean, she's so locked in, she doesn't give you any chance. It'll be very hard to get her out of here with a submission. Nice transition.
Well, as usual, suffocating work from the top here by Esparza.
Another strike gets through from the top position.
That's really good defensive awareness by the opposition. She's not going to get submitted here. Esparza's back in half guard.
Now she's in full mount.
Just over 2 minutes to go in our third and final round.
Big ground and pound.
All right, side control for her now. And you know how heavy she stays with all of that upper body strength. We'll see what she can do from here.
Well, she's got great upper body strength, and that's why she passes, because she doesn't necessarily feel she needs the legs to control her opponents on the ground. So she goes to side control and hopes that you give your back. That's right. Why you see she has so many rear naked choke submissions.
I would never give you my back.
Don't give me that.
Outstanding pressure from top position here by Carla Esparza.
Yes, smart adjustment, yep. She could get the sub here.
Esparza's looking to pass out of the half guard and attain side control here, but unable to do so. All right, full guard now, DC, and just because she has the top position does not mean she is not in imminent danger.
Oh, she's in danger at all moments whenever she's in the full guard, because they have so many different submission attempts that they can throw up at you. So she needs to pass. By passing the half guard, already eliminates a vast majority of those submissions. Move the half guard, then continue to try to advance to either get off great ground and pound or just positional advantages in the grappling.
All right, so the fighters go the distance. Pretty competitive fight, but certainly there was a striking advantage, and it was hers.
The advantage belonged to her, and you knew the longer she would be able to keep this fight upright, the better the chances were that she was going to get the victory. This fight never hit the ground, and she used that striking to win a pretty easy decision.
The official decision is in. It resides with Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for decision. All three judges score this contest 30-27. For the winner, by unanimous decision, Carla Cookie Monster Esparza!
Well, you got to figure her challenges are only going to get stiffer from here, but she passed this test tonight. She is your winner by unanimous decision.
And she needed this, right? This goes to the maturity of her career. The fact that she is growing and growing and growing and can win a tough fight over an extended period of time.